The people behind this event believe it's one of the world's toughest canoe races. The AuSable Canoe Marathon, from Grayling to Oscoda on the shores of Lake Huron in Michigan, attracts the best canoeists in North America. The event sees competitors embark on an exhausting 120-mile overnight paddle down the AuSable River. The AuSable Canoe Marathon is now in its 59th year, making it one of the oldest canoe races in the world. Most competitors will paddle for over 15 hours. There'll be little or no time to rest, eat, or even answer the call of nature. The race also involves the two-man crews crossing six hydroelectric dams. This means six portage sections, jumping out of the canoe, picking it up and running with it before getting back into the water on the other side. The competitors have got to be quick, or they'll lose the chance to compete for the $50,000 prize fund. Steve Southard is one of the organizers.
This may be the most amazing canoe race in the world. 60 or more teams running with their canoes, a Le Mans style running start to the river in front of thousands of fans. It's a real electric moment.
However, some locals and organizers believe there's a threat, not only to the future of the race, but to the very existence of this picturesque area. The Michigan Department of Environment last year issued a permit to a commercial company to dump more than 1 million gallons per day of treated groundwater into the Colca Creek, part of the AuSable River headwaters. Local conservationists believe that if the equipment fails, raw contaminants could be poured directly into the natural spring-fed water, which in turn forms one of the state's most cherished trout streams.
Part of the thing that the paddlers, that the contestants all tell me about the AuSable, other than the race itself, the reason that they like to come to Grayling and compete on the AuSable is because of the AuSable River and what a wonderful natural river it is. And with threats like we're facing now from the oil and gas industry, it's possible that may not be the case into the future.
Three, two, one, go!
But it will take more than the forces of capitalism to dampen the enthusiasm of the competitors this time around. The battle to be crowned champions is wide open after the retirement of canoe legends and last year's winners, Serge Corbin and Jeff Colca. The pair have won the demanding AuSable a remarkable 9 times. Matt Reimer and Andy Trebold, who were beaten into second place last year by a single second, are now favourites for the 2006 crown.
Last year, they say, is one of the closest finishes in marathon history, so, you know, it's exciting to be a part of that, and, you know, it's going to be talked about for a lot of years yet, so this year we're looking forward to coming out on top of that, and, you know, I guess we'll see what happens in the long run.
Reimer and Trebold display their determination to make up for their disappointment 12 months ago when they win the preliminary sprint competitions, used to determine the starting positions for the race proper. More than 50,000 spectators cram the banks of the river to watch the 66 teams battle it out over the flowing water. Novices will have been expected to train in excess of 100 hours to prepare themselves, while they're also urged to pace themselves carefully. With the support of a vocal crowd at the early stages, it's easy to set off too fast and pay a heavy price later. All crews must have lights on board to illuminate their way during night racing. For those unfamiliar with the river, the best advice is to try and stick behind a crew that knows the course. Dawn sees Reimer and Trebold fighting for second place with the Halstead brothers, Ryan and Rodney. However, the siblings from Grayling itself proceed to power past the tiring favourites. As the participants reach Cook's Dam, the surprise leaders are Alan Lindbergh and Jim Harwood. Lindbergh, from the state of Wisconsin, believes he's pulled off a masterstroke by teaming up with a local man.
It's always fun to paddle with a local boy because it's just a energy uplifter when you're going down the river and everybody goes, go Jim and Al, and it's just a, it's a fun thing.
The pair hold on to the lead to win the 2006 AuSable River Canoe Marathon. They've been paddling for 14 hours, 33 minutes and 50 seconds. The Halstead brothers came second, with last year's runner-up crew Reimer and Trebold in third. The hope here is that the AuSable will remain unspoilt, rewarding competitors and pleasure seekers alike well into the future.